At the end of posting all these data entries, we need to finally arrive at a balance for each ledger. See, for example, if you look at the cash account, you will be able to realize all that you have on debit side are of one particular nature. So all these entries has resulted in cash outflow or cash inflow that we see on the debit side.
Outflow, sir.
Inflow. Outflow or inflow?
Inflow.
Inflow. So you get cash inflows that is on the debit side, and these are all cash outflows. These are all cash receipts, and these are all cash payments. So now, in this particular period, there has been a cash inflow of 11,67,500 and cash outflow of 5,32,000. And if you take the difference between these two, this is 6,35,000. This is called balance in the account. This is called balance, or you can also call it as closing balance. Now tell me, is this right? Because it's a cash account, we can easily ascertain you cannot spend more than what we have. So naturally, the debit side of a cash account should be more than the credit side of a cash account. This is one simple rule of thumb, just to ensure a first-hand assertiveness or ascertainment that you would have done these things without errors. But we can't rule out all the errors, but at least the first instance, the debit side of the cash account should be more than the credit side of the cash account. That is the first thing. And when you have got this balance as 6,35,000, then we say cash account is showing a debit balance. Cash account is showing a debit balance. Is this clear? So how to balance? I have written here, total the debit side, total the credit side, and take the difference. That means the highest total minus lowest total. Right? So here, in case of cash account, I have totaled the debit side and I have totaled the credit side, and the debit side was more than the credit side. So I have written, I have taken the difference, and write the difference amount on the side of the more total, this side. And because the balance is on this side, I say cash account is showing a debit balance. I say a cash account is showing a debit balance. Is this clear?
Yes, sir.
Any questions?
No, sir.
Sir, can you please explain that point again, that balance?
No, I have written here. You can leisurely go through this, but I'll do it once again. See, what do you mean by balancing an account? You take the cash account. What I will do, you take the balances on both sides. Debit side balance is 11,67,500. Credit side balance is 5,32,000. This is simple arithmetic. Is it clear? Now take the difference.
Yes.
How much is the difference between the two? The highest total minus the lowest total. 6,35,000. And you write this total, this difference, on the side of highest total. This side you should write. You should not write this here. Okay? And because the debit total, this is debit total, right? Debit side total. Because debit total is more than credit total, I am writing the difference on the debit side. And I say cash account is having a debit balance. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Now let us go to equity. Equity, it is 7 lakhs. This side, it is 0. So where should I write the balance?
Debit side.
No. Credit side. This side is more, no?
Yeah, sir. Credit side.
So I write here balance. How much is the balance?
7 lakh.
7 lakh. Chiru, credit side totally 78,000, debit side totally 16,000. and the difference is 62,000. So which side I should write?
The credit side.
Credit side. So I have written balance. Now tell me, Chiru is having a debit balance or credit balance?
Credit balance.
Credit balance.
He's having a credit balance. Now likewise, you go salaries. He's showing a debit balance of 64,000 because credit side is zero. Short-term securities is again showing a debit balance of 1 lakh. Dinakar, see, debit side is 75,000, credit side is 35,000. So the difference is 40,000. Because 75,000 is more, I am writing it this side. And I am saying Dinakar is having a debit balance. Dinakar is having a debit balance. So rent paid is having a debit balance of 23, credit side is 0. Taxes paid is again having a debit balance of 25, credit side is 0. Sales commission is again having a debit balance of 3,000 because credit side is 0. Interest received is having a credit balance of 7,500 and debit side it is 0. Then insurance premium is having a debit balance of 20,000. Is balancing of ledger accounts clear to all of you? Any questions on balancing of ledger accounts? It's very, very simple. The procedure is already outlined here. I have written it here. So even when you are confused, you can go through this procedure. Now, the next step is to prepare a trial balance. Preparation of trial balance is very, very easy. We look at each ledger account. Let us say our first ledger account is what? Cash account. And this cash account is having which balance? Debit balance or credit balance? Cash account is showing debit balance or credit balance?
Debit balance.
Debit balance. How much? 6,35,000. So in trial balance, I will write account is cash account. And because it is showing a debit balance, I write here 6,35,000. That's all. What is my second account? Equity account. And equity account is showing a credit balance of 7 lakhs. So write equity account. And it is showing a credit balance of 7 lakhs. Now here I have given you a mechanism wherein you can get your accounts right here. See, your third account is building account. So building account is showing which balance?
Debit balance.
Debit balance. Debit balance of 1,25,000. Then we have the fourth account. Purchases account. The purchase account is showing a debit balance of 2,03,000. Now what is the fifth account? Fifth account is sales account. Sales account is showing a credit balance. A credit balance of 5,000. So sales account 5 lakhs. Now what is the sixth account? Advertisement expenditure is showing a debit balance of 31,000. Now seventh account, Ichiro account, it is showing a credit balance of 62,000. Then we have your 8th account, which is salaries account, which is showing a debit balance of 64,000. Then we have short-term securities, which is again showing a debit balance of 1 lakh. Dinakar account is also showing a debit balance of 40,000. Are you able to follow, please? You are able to relate what I am doing?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Then your 11th account is rent paid. Rent paid is showing a debit balance of 23,000. taxes paid. Taxes paid is again showing a debit balance of 25,000. Then you have sales commission. Sales commission is 3,000. Right, debit balance. An interest received is showing a credit balance of 7,500. An insurance premium account is showing a debit balance of 20,000. Right? Once you have taken these balances, this is called your trial balance. And see, in trial balance, one primary check is the debit side total should be equal to credit side total. 12,69,000, 12,69,000.